Hello dear students, I welcome you once again in the part number 2 of Poetic Devices. In our previous video, we have discussed first 4 poetic devices, which were simile, metaphor, alliteration and assonance. So the students, I request you to see the video if you have not watched that. Next, in this part number 2, we will see consonants, repetition, refrain and anaphora. So dear students, these poetic devices which we will do today are the repetition of something. Like in previous video, alliteration is the repetition of the consonant sound at the starting of the words, right? And assonance was the repetition of the vowel sounds within the word, we have noticed. These 5 things which I have taken today, these 5 poetic devices which I have taken today are also repetition of something. But what is repeated in these different kinds of poetic devices, let's understand with the example of, with the help of some of the examples. So when we talk about this 5th one, consonants, consonants is the repetition of the same constant consonant sounds in a line of a text or poem within the words. So what does this mean? Means we have to check the sounds of the consonant alphabets. Okay, the consonant alphabet, we have to see the sound of consonant alphabet within the words. It is not like alliteration that at the starting we have to do. It may be within the word, but that consonant sound or the consonant alphabet should be there within the words, okay, closely written words. For example, I have written here far and var. So what is which sound is being repeated, which consonant or which alphabet is being repeated here? That is what? R. So the use of R is occurring here in far and jar. So this is what? Consonants. Second example is laughed and deft. Laughed and deft. So D sound is being repeated here. Okay, laughed and deft. One thing is this, if you speak laugh and deaf, so laugh, this GH is giving the sound, but this is not the same alphabet, is not occurring here. So DD is here what? Consonants. Next one is Mike, consonants. Last one, he struck a streak of bad luck. Here K, K sound, streak, K sound and luck, K sound. So this alphabet K is being repeated, which is a consonant. So this is what? Consonants. And this is not necessary that it should be there in the starting of the words. Okay, that is not required. It may be in the starting, it may be in the middle, it may be in the last, but that should be there within the word. Okay, so that is what consonants. When we talk about the second one, means the 6th one actually, and second for today, that is repetition. So this repetition is what? Repetition is often used in the speech or in the poem as a rhetorical device to bring attention to the idea. Now let's see, this is the poem, this is these are the lines of Shakespeare poem, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. This is the poem, this is the poem written by Shakespeare, and the name of the poem is Romeo and Juliet. So he has repeated, it is not necessary that it is a word, it may be a phrase, it may be a group of word, it may be a single word. So when that is being repeated again and again in the phrase or a line, that is known as repetition. For example, here, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow, or this phrase is being repeated. So that is what? Repetition. Let's take another example of the poem of Robert Frost. A horse is a horse, of course, and no one can talk a horse. So here, a horse and a horse, this is what? This is what? Repetition of word horse is being done in this example. Next one is, again I have taken an example of Shakespeare's poem, my conscience hath a thousand several tongues, and every tongue brings a several tale. several tales, sorry, and every tale condemned me to be a villain, right? So this is what here, which words or which phrases are being repeated, like several tongues, or see this word several is being repeated here, several is being repeated here, tongues is being repeated, but here it is what? Tongue, right? This is not tongues, so this is not repetition, this is not same actually. Every is being repeated, and is being repeated, tail is being repeated, but here it is tails, so that cannot be the same. So when the words are being repeated at different places in a poem, in a stanza, that is known as repetition. Again, we have to see the next one, that is the seventh one, that is the name of that is refrain. So this refrain is occurrence of refrain is there when in a line or in a stanza or a phrase is being repeated after a proper interval of time, actually within a poem, especially in the end of the stanzas, to give the stress to that particular line, right? To emphasize that particular line, that what is the meaning of that. The best example of this you have seen in your 9th class poem, that is The Duck and the Kangaroo. So in every stanza, when you will go through that poem, you will come to know every stanza is having the duck said this to the kangaroo, the duck said this to the kangaroo. In every stanza, and by the end of every stanza, you will see this poem, this line actually. So when a line or a phrase is being repeated to give the stress to something, to emphasize something, this is known as refrain, right? Next one, the last one for today, is anaphora, where something once again is being repeated. So that is what? That is very interesting actually. You have to learn actually, because something is being repeated. So what is being repeated in which? That you have to take care. Last one for today is anaphora. And anaphora is a figure of speech which repeats at the beginning of the successive clauses or the consecutive lines, or to create a sonic effect, means the continuation with music, right? So for example, this is the stanza I have prepared for you here. Suppose this is the stanza of a poem, or I have started writing a poem and I have used such type of lines in the poem, okay? See that this is 4 lines stanza here, and you will notice that the first line is I was roaming in dash dash, what do you want to write down? And second line, I was watching dash dash dash. Third line, suddenly I noticed. And in fourth line, I was amazed at. Clear? So here in first line and second line, you will notice this I was and I was. It is not necessary, it should be the phrase. It may be a single word also, it may be a phrase also. When this is being repeated in the successive clauses also and in consecutive lines of the stanza, that is known as anaphora. Means this is what? This is the repetition of the same word or the same phrase at the beginning of the stanza in the different lines. In the consecutive lines, this is very important. In the consecutive line, it should be. Consecutive means one after one. Like I was, I was. So first line and second line is having the same beginning, that is I was, I was. Clear? It may be I, it may be I, it may be any other word. So it is what you have noticed. In the consecutive line, the same words or the same phrases are being repeated. Here also it is I, here also it is was. So I was. Please, clear? So this is the occurrence of anaphora. What is this? This is anaphora. So what you will write down in first and second line, I was, this first and second line is starting with I was, so that's why there is occurrence of anaphora in this stanza. Now one more thing I want to tell you, the third line I have started with suddenly, means there is no similarity, clear? And here I is given, so that is not at all anaphora here. That may be repetition of I in the different stanza, but that is not in the line. Next thing you have to notice here, the fourth line itself is starting with I was amazed at. So I was, here there is no occurrence of I was, because there is a gap of the third line which is not starting with the same phrase. Here it is starting with suddenly. So this first and second line is having anaphora, but this fourth line is not having the occurrence of anaphora. This is very important. So dear students, I hope you understood these all eight poetic devices. Once again, you did it last year also. So this is very important question which will be there in your question paper, and be prepared for this and start studying by the first day of your session. And please note down all these eight poetic devices as the first topic in your literature notebook, so that it will help you in your future. Thank you very much. Please note it down and try to find out the different poetic devices in the different writings or the different speeches. It is not necessary that in the poetry it will be there. You may get that in the different articles of the newspaper. And one important thing I want to advise you, for a proper and a good reading or effective reading, there is a need of reading the newspaper or the books or the story daily. So this is my advice for you, because this is going to help you in the reading section, which is quite different in the previous classes, and this time the standard is uplifted. So please just prepare yourself for that challenge also. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay healthy. We will meet in next video with the next four poetic devices. Thank you.